When you combine ComfyUI with Python, the results can really become endless. Here's how. So first up, you'll want to install the ComfyUI Tooling Nodes custom node. This allows you to send and receive images, particularly if you have ComfyUI installed on a separate web server. Additionally, head to Settings and then enable Dev Mode within ComfyUI. This allows you to save your workflows as API files. And then within LightGraph, you'll just want to make sure that the Node ID Badge Mode is turned to Show All. This allows us to reference this in our Python file later on and makes it a little bit easier to kind of suss out everything. So here's a basic image generation workflow. I'm just going to adapt this to an image-to-image workflow for this demonstration today. So in the node search here, I'm going to bring in this load image base64. So we're going to basically convert that image to a base64 file and then send it to ComfyUI. And this was be new from the ComfyUI tooling nodes. And just like a load image node, we're going to encode it and then send this off to our K sampler and then also connect the VAE. Now, importantly here is notate the number on this node. This is number 10. We're going to have to reference this or update our Python file later on in just a moment. And then whenever we save the image, we could save the image to the server if we wanted to. However, I want to receive it. So you can put in the send image WebSocket. And this is also provided by the Comfy tooling nodes. Now, the sample image that I'm working with here is just a cup of coffee and a croissant. But I want to have New York City in the background. So to do that, I'm just going to update my prompt really quick. Coffee and croissant with New York City in the background. And I'm going to change out my denoise value to 0.8 and just drop out this empty latent image node. And that's about it. So basically what's going on here is the Comfy tooling nodes are the start and the end of this entire workflow. And what happens in the center doesn't really matter. We just have our input and our output endpoint. So this is where it's really powerful because you can adapt the workflows to whatever you could possibly want. If you want to add in control nets, IP adapters, doesn't really matter. That is all kind of contained between these two nodes. So you can really just fire off these from Python without always having to go into the ComfyUI interface. So whenever we save this workflow, I'm just going to export as API, and then I'm just going to call this workflow. So popping over to Visual Studio Code now, I have my server address. I do not run Comfy locally here on the Mac. I have a separate Windows computer that's running. So I'm speaking with that over the network here. But you could just put in a local host address too, and this would work no problem. Now I used Anthropic's Claude Sonnet to write most of this, but I'll just kind of give you a high level overview of what's going on. So it's reading the workflow file. It's encoding that image to a base64. And then it will queue that or send that off to the server, as you can see here, to the prompt endpoint. And then whenever it goes to get the image, it's going to receive that over the WebSocket. And then we'll go ahead and save that image locally onto this Macintosh computer. Now, as you can see, we're just sending a sample image, but you could say read an entire directory of images and pass them through this workflow or whatever it is that you want to do within Python. The results can really be endless. And just as a quick reference, I had mentioned earlier that ComfyUI ID for this load image, we just want to make sure that that is correct within here, which it is. The value is 10, but if you had a different ID, you'd want to update that value. And we also have our workflow that we downloaded within the same directory. And again, if you wanted to really extend out this main.py file, you could change out like a search and replace some of the text here, whatever it might be, to really kind of alter things however you could possibly want in a programmatic way. So now let's fire off this request to the server. I'm just going to start Python here. And as you can see, it's going through the 20 steps to generate that image. and then it will save it right into our directory. So here was our original reference image, and then here's our generated image. Awesome. So that's it with generating images with ComfyUI and Python. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you did, hit that thumbs up, consider subscribing. If you have any questions, drop it in the comments below. And lastly, all these files are available on the Prompting Pixels website, so you can go there to check them out. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.